to the class students. In our previous class in computer, we have done up to speaker, and we know speaker is an additional part. And next, there are two additional parts remains, and let's start that. Number 6 is optical drive. Now, what is optical drive? You may not understand, but if I say CD, then you can understand very easily. So CD is actually called disc. Okay, disc. But to run this, that CD, that means suppose you have one movie CD or game CD, but to run that CD, you need one player or one some machine that in that the CD can run or play. That is optical drive. Okay, you can see this CD is actually called disc, and this machine where we put the CD, it is optical drive. So optical disc contains video, audio and other information data. So this contains movie, video, games and information or data. And to read optical disc or CD, to read this optical disc or CD, we need optical drive. That means this machine. That is in the CPU, or those who have one laptop, they also have one space for optical drive. Got it? So this is optical drive. Optical drive is also known as disk drive. We simply say disk drive because it runs the disk. Next is USB drive. Now what is USB drive? The picture is like this. Very small. Okay. USB drive is very small, and we have to connect this in computer or laptop or in the mobile. You can use that one. It is one portable storage device. Size is small and we call it pen drive. Actually, USB drive is literally known as pen drive. It is very small in size and it is a portable storage. That means you can store many more data in it and you can carry it anywhere with you. So that is pen drive. We use pen drive to store many things. Movies, games, songs, or any information or data, everything. And we can carry this everywhere. That is pen drive. Next comes the last part. We know in our first class, I have told you that computer, first we have to give instruction to the computer. Then computer will calculate that information or instruction. And then computer will show us the result, that whatever happened. So computer first we have to give instruction, then computer will calculate it, and then they will show us the result. So this giving instruction or any command to the computer is known as input. That means you have to input or give instruction to the computer. Then calculation, this part is known as process. That means computer will do his calculation, but we don't have to know about this right now. Next, give result means computer will show you the result. Suppose you want to know something, there is one math, you have put give instruction to the computer that what is the result of this math. Then computer will calculate and computer will show you the result. That is output. Got it? So, and there are, suppose you have one pencil and your pencil's nib is very blunt. You can't write nicely. So what you will do? You will take one eraser and will sharpen your pencil. Right? So here your pencil is the blunt pencil. Okay, the blunt pencil is input. The pencil sharpener, that is calculation or process, and then output is you will get one sharp nib pencil. Okay, that is input, process and output. So input, so that means what are the parts or things that we use to give computer the instruction or command? That are keyboard, scanner, camera, microphone or mic or mouse. We use all these instruction. And output devices are monitor, printer, speaker. They are output device. That means we get the result through monitor, printer and speaker. Got it? Simply saying, without keyboard, you can't type anything in computer. So you can't do any input. And without the monitor, you can't see anything in computer. So you will not get your result. So that's why these are input device, these are output device. But whatever you have to remember here is disk drive and pen drive. This disk drive and pen drive, they act both as input and output device. As they can store the data, they also can show us the data. So that's why disk drive and pen drive are both input device and output device. So today we have completed the second class, our second chapter. So read in your home thoroughly and then we'll move to the exercise part. Till then.